just had to pick some dogs to be our camera operators, and I was thinking that I think Corey should be one of them, seeing as he wanted to be the camera operator in the last episode as well. And then I just need to pick one other dog to operate the other camera. So let's have Benji. Would you like to be one? Yes, I'm going to take that as a yes. I don't know why I always ask them to make the school look up at me. Yes, I would love to be one. And where's Corey as well? Corey should be... Where is Corey? Corey should be somewhere around town. Corey's right here in the corner. Corey Gordon, he was in down there. And yeah, see, that's how he looked like. And he was doing in the last episode. And you can go and help him. And who's supposed to be making... of the show where you at home get to test your quizzy, busy skills with our interactive poll. This week's question is, if I wasn't an elephant, what animal would I be? A. Panda. B. C. Chicken. Or D. Cookie. Vote now. Right, on with the show. We are now moving into the final round. This is the description round. In this round, I'm going to describe an object, and the first person to guess what it is wins 100 points. Let's get started. Most people own two of them. They can be decorated with pieces of metal. I like to flap them around. They rhyme with deer. They are on your head.
Oh, wait a minute. I know what it is. Is it ears?
Ears! They are ears. That was the correct answer. Congratulations to Molly. You are the winner of tonight's show, and your prize is a meal with me tonight. Although you do have to pay for it. Thank you for everyone watching. We will be back at the same time next week for another round of Quizzy Fizzy. Goodbye.
Fastest way for us.
first, let's go and try and get the outside of this pyramid built. So it's going to be like a stairs pyramid. So there's going to be stairs on the outside of it. But first we're going to build the blocks and then just place the stairs on top of the blocks. Because then I just...
Just putting the coals in the basket though. If you can't see what I'm doing, it's a little dark. Well, I am recording this like early in the morning, like around like 7 o'clock. I got a few pieces of garbage left to pick up over here. Basically two types of washers, reloaded from the top or loaded there in the middle. So if you hear if you heard of this before and just watching, just listening to us, Steppy Long Nose, Steppy, which he renamed Steppy Longhead.
21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, and 33. Right, so that's 33 that way. And do one of you want to check that as well, just to make sure I got it right? And I'm going to go and build in this direction. So this needs to be the same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, and 33. I just ran out of blocks. Right, this tree sadly has to go because we need to make room for a giant pyramid. So hopefully, if this is all linked up correctly, this should make the giant box. Then we kind of just need to build up. And oh, hello, Polly. That's a good sign, though. The fact that it linked up is a good sign. So yeah, this is how big the game is. And you might say, well, it doesn't look that big, but it is pretty big, and it's going to be going up very tall as well. So what we need to do now is start building up. So we're just going to place down some dirt here, just so I can place this first block. And then we're going to go and keep building up like this. So we're going to do this the entire way up to make the kind of the outside pyramid shape. And then all we need to do is go and make a bunch of sandstone stairs, and we're just going to place them straight on the on top of those blocks. And while we do this, I'm going to finally let you know what this game is. So it's basically, it's kind of like a it's kind of like a hide and seek game, but with a bit of a twist. So the idea is there's going to be four entrances to this pyramid, and so there's going to be basically like four doorways in the middle of each of these sides, okay? And one of them is going to have a button, and what's going to happen is it's going to be one seeker and the rest are going to be hiders. And so the seeker is going to press the button, which is going to open up the door for just a second, so he can then go in. At the same time, all of the hiders are going to climb up the pyramid and drop down here a hole, which is going to be in the top, in the middle of the pyramid. And so then they need to go and try and find as good a hiding place as they can, and then the seeker needs to try and find them. The twist is that when the seeker does find them, the hiders then become seekers as well, and have to go around and carry on trying to find everyone else. But after a certain time limit,